Hi, I'm David from the Questacon Science Squad, and today we're going to be cooking with science because I'm going to show you how to make some really, really cool ice cream. Now, this is what you're going to need. A nice bowl with some ice in the bottom of it and a thermometer, some table salt. Now, your ice cream ingredients: thickened cream, a flavor, we're going to go with vanilla, some sugar. Now, you're going to need some spoons as well, a nice mixing spoon and a spoon to pour your salt and your sugar into the ice cream with. And of course, another bowl. We're using a plastic one, but use a metal one if you can find them. They work a lot better. Now, first off, I want you to have a look at your thermometer and have a look at what temperature the ice is. Then grab your little spoon here and spoon some ice, or some salt, on top of the ice there and give it a good mix around so that salt gets around everywhere. Now, after you've given it a good mix and left it for a few minutes, have a look at what temperature your ice is. Now, it'll probably be a little bit colder. Okay, now we can get down to making our ice cream. So take out the thermometer, put that to the side, and move your bowl so it's nice in the middle of the ice there. Okay, first ingredient, your thickened cream. Pour a nice dollop of that in the bottom. That should be plenty. And your flavor, we're using vanilla, remember? So pour a bit of a splash around there, however much you like. And then, last but not least, especially for the sweet tooths, we have got some very tasty caster sugar. So we'll go 1 teaspoon, 2 teaspoons, 3 teaspoons, that should be plenty. Now, this is the fun part. You've got to mix your ice cream around, your vanilla essence and your sugar and your cream, for about 8 or 9 minutes. Now, it won't be frozen and ready to eat after 8 or 9 minutes. After that, you've got to put some more salt on your ice, give it a mix around, then stir it again for another 8 or 9 minutes, and after that, it should be ready. But I don't really want to wait that long. So today, we're going to make our ice cream a little bit differently using stuff that you can't always get at home: liquid nitrogen. This stuff's great, but I've also got to take some special safety precautions, so I'm going to put on my safety goggles and my safety gloves. There's one hand and two. All right, so I'll get rid of that little spoon there and I will bring out my big mixing spoon and pour in the liquid nitrogen. There we go, that should be plenty to start with. Give it a bit of a pour. I've got to make sure I get all the liquid nitrogen mixed in with my ice cream. There's lots and lots of fog. Now you might be thinking, this is pretty dangerous, isn't it? Using liquid nitrogen to make ice cream, if I eat that, I'll die, but you won't. Because all that liquid nitrogen turns into nitrogen gas and bubbles and boils away, and we don't even taste it at all. It's not even there when we eat it. Use a little bit more now, pour it in. There we go. Mixing it around nicely, that's getting nice and cold. Oh, look at that, almost finished now. Yeah, a little bit more, once more. Now, liquid nitrogen ice cream also is some of the creamiest and tastiest ice cream you'll ever make. It's absolutely great. I think it's just about ready to taste some now. Still not completely frozen. Get a bit from the side maybe. Ooh. Where are we? There we go. Still not completely frozen, but let's have a taste. Mmm. That's good. Now, if you want to find more about making ice cream or making liquid nitrogen ice cream, you can head on down to the Questacon website. I'll see you next time.